Previously, I once suffered from depression. And I learned that nobody can understand this unless they go through this. The same applies to disabilities. And as a Korean Canadian, I realized disability awareness in Korea can be improved. So even though I don't have disabilities, I decided to cross 800 kilometers of Santiago pilgrimage on a wheelchair. Day 1 was Mountain Pirene, 3,400 meters in altitude, aka the most infamous. Even walking pilgrims, tons of them, give up on this course and either get a cab or stay at a burger in the middle. That's how hard it is. I clearly remember this moment when we reached for Calles.
Our official first destination, right?
Yeah.
We feel so unshaped
today. So I feel
it was the very first village we went through. It was a gorgeous village with incredible views. And when we were passing by some stores, there was a bell ringing throughout the village. It sounded very exotic and relaxing. We need some rest, so we went to a restaurant, had a good meal, had a good conversation with good people. What else would I need? After our lunch, we went on. We just went on and went on. In the middle of this super high hill, we met some new friends from Norway.
So this is my new friends from all around the world.
Yeah.
And what's the purpose for you guys?
Well, I met someone last summer who had literally just finished the Camino, and he ended up walking all the way down to the south of Spain.
Right.
And he told me about it, and then I said, let's do that.
These beautiful girls told me they carry a tent and sleep on the road. How brave, right? We talked for a bit there. Nothing was like my training back in Korea. It was much harder. My wrist, that was kind of injured during my training, started feeling a little weird. I had to be very careful on how to grab handles. Was it my wrist that had hurt the most? Not even close. The biggest discomfort was coming from my butt and back. It was surely irritating to be seated on a wheelchair for too long. If there's anyone preparing for a Camino on a wheelchair, don't forget your cushion. Seriously, it was my number one mistake. Did you know that there are ways to get free food in Camino? Sunberry. It's like a smaller version of Blackberry, but it tastes amazing. We were willing to eat up the whole forest. That's how good it was. We went through another village. I forgot what it's called, but I like this one too. It looks very cute. And we stopped at this convenience store to shop for snacks. I got a few chocolate bars and Jang got some drinks.
Thank you.
But those chocolate bars didn't help much, I guess, because later, we both got extremely exhausted. From a certain point, we weren't even talking at all, simply because we just couldn't. But the real problem was something else. So we took too many breaks because of the hills. Even though I was on a wheelchair for like 10 hours, we still had 7 more hours to go. Poor time management. Even worse, one driver said it would be getting dark outside soon. We had to get a cab. No other choice. When we arrived at Arberge in Roncesvalles, I felt miserable.
근데 내일 코스도 아마 좀 힘들 거야. 어떤 루트로 가? 그 좀 보도가 있기 때문에.
네, 7시쯤만 이거 무조건 바로 출발해야 되겠다. 7시 5분에는 무조건 출발하는 걸로 해야 될 것 같아.
I felt like I ruined the whole thing. I talked to Jang and Marcelo for a long time. They suggest that I should stop being on a wheelchair once I get into Arberge, because not every Arberge is equipped with enough facilities. Also, Jang and I were freaking exhausted. They said it makes more sense strategically to get a proper rest. Eventually, we decided to do so.
So day first over, somehow. It was the longest day I ever had. I was super tiring. So yeah, we are very excited for tomorrow. And hopefully it's gonna be easier than what we went through today.
And I fell asleep right away. Good night. Any course is not as hard as day one. Relatively speaking, everything was pretty fine after mountain terrain. Except for these obstacles. Because of these little things that we don't even usually notice, I had to turn around to go through. Imagine how burdensome it would be if we have to do that every single day.
Those are really important because, you know, those little things on the road that we don't even recognize is there,
yeah,
when we're walking. And it becomes like the biggest obstacle when I'm on a wheelchair because I just can't go through. I need someone else's help.
No. No.
I
don't want to help you.
In Camino, you can find many of these bars in the middle of the road. It's like an oasis. And one cup of Coke with ice
can
bring you back to life.
You guys look a little tired too.
At a different bar, I met this beautiful woman named Sylvia. Isn't she lovely? She told me her legs became weak and she had a limp. So it was her big challenge. Just like I was doing my own challenge. I really liked her, and we started sharing life stories.
Oh my God, it must be so challenging for you.
I need your chair.
When she had to leave, we wished a good luck to each other.
So on the second day, which was today, it was as tough as the first day, but this time we made it. So at the very moment we entered this village, Subiri, we almost scream out of the excitement because it was very fulfilling. And I really appreciate Jang's effort because I would probably not be able to do this without him.
When we were on our way to Pamplona, it rained a little. Even though it was 9 a.m. in the morning at the time, it was pretty dark outside. So I had to wear my life vest that was meant to reflect the light and keep me safe. On this day, we saw many other pilgrims.
It's a wonderful day, isn't it?
Yes, I don't like it that much.
It was very nice to see them. We didn't get to see them too often because we were usually on the road for cars.
That'll make it even harder.
For someone.
Look, a lot more at the back.
Hello.
This course was one of the worst. Pretty rocky. It's not so clear in the video, but on the course like this, I needed to put 10 times more force to go forward. And yeah, crazy, right? I had to be completely dependent on Zhang. I couldn't do anything. Zhang even had to lift up the wheelchair and me with another person who helped him. Zhang did so much work. So much. Did I feel comfortable just being on a wheelchair? No. Absolutely no. I felt devastatingly helpless. He was gasping and dying because of me, and there was not a single thing that I could do for him. You know, having disability is not only about physical challenges. It's that moment when you feel like a chunk of burden on people you cherish.
Yeah, I need a little help.
Don't get me wrong though. I am completely aware that my little project doesn't mean I have a right to speak on behalf of disability.
Okay, so can you help me, Zhang? Zhang?
I'm just thinking. What can I do to make a better society? What can we do to make a happier world? I believe it's not the answer that matters. It's the question we ask ourselves.
This is municipal, right?
Yeah.
Who did it? Wow. Temple End. Yes.
Woo! So, finally, we're at the Pamplonian, which is one of the biggest city at Santiago. Mm-hmm. So we went through so many things together. But we did it. We made it together, Zhang. Mm-hmm. That's it. That's all I would say. Mm-hmm.